catch them in the pasture, run them in the pen, work them on the Sundays, do it all again, race them in the sand.
The Elite Rodeo Athletes World Championship, the greatest ever anywhere. The Elite Rodeo Athletes World Championship, the greatest ever anywhere. Three big shows, November 11th, 12th, and 13th. American Airlines Center, Dallas. 37 world champions. 135 world championship titles. With $1 million on the line. Take part in the ultimate fan experience beginning Thursday, November 10th. 4 days of Western shopping, athlete interaction, and live entertainment at the ERA Expo. Free to the public. Reserve your seats today. Details at erarodeo.com.
What are you talking about? You talking about stuff over there? What are you guys talking about? What is going on over there?
It sounds like we need to come pull you out of a well.
Well, I'm here, they say. Well, what you talking about? There's Tex. Gay Possa. There's a Wild Bill Steven.
Wild, that's a first.
Wild Bill Steven?
That's
the
first. I haven't heard that one before. I've heard Stevie Reno. I've heard lots of. I've been called worse.
Oh,
if you want to go with Wild Bill,
have you?
We'll go with it.
So have you?
I have.
Well, you guys are tuned in to the unscripted, unedited, wild, and we don't know what we're gonna do. Pepper Stewart Show. We're here, guys. We got papers. I don't know what they say. All right. I'm sorry about that, but we got papers. Why is that? I can't tell you. Or can I tell you?
People winning money. People are gonna win money this weekend.
Yes.
Needs to be me.
What are you talking? Who won? Who won something?
Some woman in New York won the money in a malfunction casino.
Or did she?
Or did she, yeah.
I'm going to Las Vegas in a couple of weeks. Maybe I can win some money that way.
Maybe you ought to redress that story.
Yeah. Yeah. You may not want to go if you read that.
Oh, okay.
We can read it later. Let's kick it off here.
Leave it suspense.
We'll kick it off. You guys are tuned into the world-renowned, award-winning awards on that wall. Pepper Stewart Show, we're here every week for you guys. Each and every week we're here. You never know who's going to be here, what we're going to talk about, or what we're going to do, but I can tell you this, we're going to be here. Unless it's Thanksgiving. If it's Thanksgiving, we ain't going to be here.
We're gonna be eating.
They're gonna be gobbling,
decorating
gobbling now.
I got cookie food to decorate.
Tex has been decorating. He has become the interior decorator of the show.
Yeah, we need to talk about that at some point too. You know.
I'm done looking for a wife. I'm even decorating my own house.
There you go.
All right.
No, I'm not done yet.
What?
Not
what?
Completely.
Huh? Well, we went somewhere today. We went down to this place here. I don't know what's going on. Whoa, what's going on right there? Look at there. There we are. Downtown Dallas, the ERA World Final starts tomorrow. So we went down there today.
And there was no protest going on there.
But we did our own protest in the parking garage. And we walked back and forth a few times trying to figure out where we're going to go.
Absolutely.
So we got the protest department handled, so we're good. We're good to go. You know, I wondered about that last night when I was watching the news. I was like, I hope they're not down by the American Airlines Center because we got to go there tomorrow. And then I look at the background, I see the ERA commercial playing during the protest. I was like, you know what? I guess we're going to go. Maybe they go to work the next day. They won't be down there. So it all worked out. Something. I don't know what this guy was talking about or doing, but he was there too.
How come it looks like we're all sitting on the same side of the table here?
That's called trick photography. That's how things work in 2016.
Oh, there's his shot where he's practicing to run for president against Trump next time.
Inauguration. How about this shot right here? I don't know. It does not matter where we go, at least in North Texas, wherever we go to cover stuff, do stuff. Well, there's Mesquite. Anywhere we go, They always find time to put this guy to work. I don't get this.
Yeah.
This guy's working. He's back there working, running steers, sorting bulls, moving horses, and what? He's supposed to be doing media. Who is that guy anyway? I don't know who that guy
is. You gotta work. Can't get that around. You gotta work.
Huh?
You gotta work.
You gotta what?
You gotta work.
You also gotta talk.
You gotta work that pole.
Yeah, he's talking to the microphone, dude.
Oh, what? You gotta work that pole.
You gotta work the pole.
What?
He said work the pole. He was working a bunch of poles. There were panels.
Oh, there's panels. Moving stuff. We're doing stuff.
But I like your thought process.
Yeah. Can I hear you now?
Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now? Hola.
I guess I can hear you.
Como esta?
My mic don't work.
I don't know. If they can't hear you, I'm sure somebody will tell us.
If you can't hear us, type it in.
That's a possibility. We did run into some folks down there. It was pretty entertaining down there. Ran into some folks at the ERA deal. So that was good.
Tiffany said, hey, guys.
Who's that? Tennessee Tiffany? We are live. Those of y'all that listen in on the watch the replay or listen later, you know, you missed out on the live feed part of it. You know, everybody keeps telling me I need to make a video. I don't know. They're like, you need to make a video saying, if you see me right now, that's how you watch the show. Because it's a video.
If you see me right, if you see me right now, I'll tell you what. Say it one more time.
Well, you gotta explain it because people
I'm just trying to follow you. I like
it. Well, if you see me, then that's how you watch the show.
Well, that's true. Because well, that's a very profound statement.
It's a video show. So people say, how do I catch the show? Well, it's a video.
You watch it, right?
You watch it.
There
yeah.
you go. I like, yeah.
So it's like I explain to folks sometimes in different areas of thought processes. It's like, you know, it's kind of like Netflix. You know, you watch Netflix. You watch movies on Netflix. Well, you watch us kind of the same way.
That's right. That's right. Hey, Mark Pierce, there's one of my guys from Higher Ground Cowboy Church out there, I see. Joined in on us.
We'll make sure Steve pays you that $5.
$5, that's it, $5.
He owes you $5.
Can I borrow $5 so I can pay my debt?
Tex has got that. Tex can handle that up for you.
Never mind. We're good.
What happened?
I'm tired, man, from chasing you around up at the ERA all day.
Don't get scared. Oh, we were working. We were busy.
I know, but
we got a whole bunch of good shots over there.
We went 5 miles around Sunday today, man.
Well, we missed out.
It was fun, though.
We missed out on the walking around Dallas last night, so we made up for it today.
Well, I didn't get to go to Canton last weekend, so I thought I was, making up that exercise.
Oh, yeah. Always making up exercise.
Everybody, Tiffany said she hears us loud and clear.
Well, that's good. I'm glad you can hear us.
Anybody can hear me talk.
We'd be wondering.
Oh, somebody calling them.
Or are we calling somebody?
Oh. Hello, hello. Uh-oh.
Let's see if we can get somebody on the phone. We'll do a little recap if we catch somebody.
Is this going where I think it's going?
I have no clue. I do have a phone call to make, though. We've made last
show. Yeah, you tell me about it.
I'm going to make it, too.
And if that's the case, we're going to Hawaii, right?
That's right. If it's a person right here.
Hey, Reach Bonnie.
Oh, look out.
Oh, Bonnie, she did that to us, really.
Look at that. She is asleep on the job.
Hey, where's she at right now?
She's probably mad at me.
Louisiana.
Oh, well, there ain't no time change, so I guess she could be.
What should be mad at you for, old Tejas?
I'm getting too
forward.
Yeah.
That's the word you're looking for.
Not you.
I don't know what I'm looking for.
Taking those pictures?
Yeah.
Instead of them coming at you, they're catching them on their way out? I love it. Just kidding. I love it.
So what else is going on, guys?
Katie said Bonnie is wore out.
Oh, yeah. Busy stuff.
That's right. We're just kidding around anyway.
I'm going to ring a ding this number here. Ask for my money.
Ooh, here we go. I like it.
I won money right here.
That's what it said.
See if these folks answer.
No, it's after 4.
Are they at home? How am I going to ever get my money if they don't answer the phone? Hello?
We're sorry. This person is not available right now.
Why not?
Please leave a message after the beep.
Hello, this here is John Randall. I saw on Facebook I won $800,000. I need my money. I need to get my house paid off. My truck payment's late. My dog needs surgery. And my cat's got explosive diarrhea. Please call me back. All right.
That was 800.000.000.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's a lot of dots. There wasn't a comma in it. So
it's a lot of money.
There's
though.
Some kind of glitch in there.
It's a lot of
like
money.
Kind of like that lady in New York.
You didn't leave a phone number. How are they going to call you?
Oh.
Caller ID, man. This is the new age.
They got my email.
That's right. They got the email.
With the voice recognition software, I'm sure they could figure out who it was.
They'd know that voice anywhere.
I just had to call the promo coordinator right there.
That's
from
right.
Facebook.
I saw the letter. It's legit.
Right here. Legitimacy right here. Those of you that tuned in to previous episodes, y'all heard the story about this here. On Facebook, I won $800,000 here. That's what it says.
Tiffany said your cat don't have the diarrhea that you do.
Tex, you got what?
No, Tiffany said that.
Oh. Tiffany? Mm-hmm. Tiffany's got diarrhea.
Something like that.
What? Why? It's part of Tennessee, I guess.
You want to call my guy from hit?
Call your guy. What are you going to tell your guy?
It's in my direct line.
Hello.
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 Hello, Governor.
Hello.
So what happened at the PBR World...
What's happening?
PBR World Finals. What happened? You were there. Tell us something.
Well, I think... yes, I was there more physically than mentally, I think. But, hey, you know, we had a great silent auction for our rider relief. We raised some money and to help our guys. And Mr. Cooper Davis brought home that big old trophy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And Mr. Dirt Eater was our final champion. So it was a great week. It really was. And the Cooper Davis deal, you know, me and you were talking how back in February when I interviewed him at the American, he had won the finals, the finals the year before, and he said he was ready to go back and get the trophy. And I guess he was speaking. He was telling us a future right there, buddy, because he was ready.
He was.
He knew then.
He did it. He might be a time traveler.
I know it. It was awesome. And I got, yeah. I got to meet his family, his wife, and little boy, and his parents. And they are such sweet people, such genuine people. His dad was in tears, made me cry. It was a great night.
Yeah, we saw you photobomb him.
Everybody, you know, I didn't photobomb him. They let me in that picture. I was in it. I saw that and I was like, oh God, that makes people gonna think I'm a creeper.
Let me start calling you text.
I was like, no, Pepper. I look now. That's fighting words right there.
Where's the love?
Look, I barely have time to recuperate and get ready to go back to NFR.
Now you get to go deal with Tex. How about that?
That's something.
You got to give me some advice.
That's more fighting words right there, okay?
You going to give me some advice to fall off Vegas?
Tex, I'm writing out a rule book. When I'm talking, you have to stop talking so you can listen to me.
Okay.
You understand?
Okay.
Now, I'm writing out a rule book.
I'm getting a book.
Okay.
That's right. A rule book, and you have to sign it every day.
you got yourself an accountability partner right here. Isn't that what you needed?
I need an accountability partner. I need one. Help me stay out of trouble.
Oh, he will be accountable. For sure.
I just don't want you to interfere with me and potential...
Oh no, he said he's worried you're going to interfere with his potential, and then he left it blank.
Well, there's plenty of those walking up down the street that you're talking about. You were talking about pole work a while ago. I'm sorry, I got mixed up.
Just make sure you got $200 in your pocket, because the girl at the bar has a drink with you. She might want $200 later.
Yeah.
So
either way, it's going to cost you $200.
So other than having to deal with tax, what else happened up there at the final of the PBR?
I think we lost Bonnie.
Or did you go away? I think you dropped her off.
Hello.
Bonnie.
Oh.
Come back. What happened? We know over in Louisiana, down in the swamp, they don't have cell towers. We'll find out.
Hey there.
Do they have
cell, hear me now.
They have cell towers in the swamp of Louisiana.
Yeah, I lose signal out here.
Go sit on the roof.
Hey, I know, right? Hey, you tell Tex, I will fire him if he don't have it right.
I just don't want you to interfere with my potential.
Nothing.
Nothing.
He's got.
What'd he say?
He said he's got potential something up there. He doesn't know what, but he said he's got some kind of potential.
And I don't want you in the field.
If he gets all it, if he does what I ask him to do, I'll help him.
Hey man, it don't get any better than a female wingman. Trust me.
Find you a date.
I need all the help.
We'll find you a date. Hey, I think. Farmers Only convention the same weekend.
Speaking of Farmers Only, he's got some.
I think I have a date this weekend in Dallas.
Some Farmers Only girl texted him today, said she was flying in tonight to be at the rodeo.
You gotta book the hotel in Dallas.
Tomorrow night, she booked the hotel for the rodeo tomorrow night so she can meet him after the rodeo.
Oh, goodness.
No, I'm not going to.
I hear they're going to have a booth at Cowboy Christmas. You better watch out. They're going to be selling all kinds of stuff.
Oh, all kinds of dates. You can get some good stuff in Vegas for sale.
Some scary stuff, too, I'm sure.
Oh, he likes that stuff.
Oh, gosh. That's a whole other talk show.
Oh, man. So you had a good time in Vegas, I guess, checking out PBR Bull Ride in action?
Yes, sir. I tell you, some good folks. I really enjoyed working with them, and I get to meet.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Well.
What's going on?
Alligator got her.
Hello.
She's gone. Alligator. All right.
Tennessee Tiffany said she sits on the roof to watch the Pepper Stewart show. They must have bad signal up there, too.
Way up yonder way in Tennessee.
Brandon Wren. What's up, Brandon? Hey.
Where? What happened?
I just get on the roof of my house if it
does. Yeah, we know.
To watch neighbors.
How about we hear some tunes? How about this, guys? We're going to throw a tune in your ear holes. We're going to conglomerate over here. Get some of these good. We got some good stories. We've been busy, tied up all day. We don't had no time for show prep, which, you know, what is that? We don't do it when we don't have stuff to do. But anyway, we're going to come back and talk about stuff right now. Let's throw some Doc Westband in your ear holes, man. Good stuff right here from these guys, so you will enjoy.
Tennessee to bog down in the mud. On the back
going on, folks? What's up with that? I got.
We kept falling. We keep falling back down in this well.
Well time. No, it's because the contraption in this two-eyed jack studio here. We got to configure this thing to where it works. Where it works right. I don't know. What story you got? Who's got a story? What can you tell me? Tell me something, because we got a request to Wild Bill Tex from someone to call him. So we're gonna ring a ding ding them, see what's up with that.
Yeah, somebody called me. Yeah, you know.
Or texted you, was like, hey, call me. So like, why'd you text? Why didn't you just call? I don't know.
Email. Give me email.
Oh, sent you an email. Okay. Tell me a story, and then we'll ring a ding ding this person, see what the deal is.
Well, you want to pick, you want to hear about somebody winning the lottery?
Yes.
$43 million?
All right.
And a yacht with a malfunction.
What?
The casino offered a state dinner instead.
No, I'll take that 40. I think I'll take that $43 million.
Mm-hmm.
You want to take that? You want to do a steak dinner?
No.
A New York casino offered a woman a steak dinner after claiming her $43 million machine victory was the result of a malfunction.
Well, that's what I'd say, too. If I had a casino and I was about to give away about $43 million, I'd be like, look, sorry, oh, that machine messed up here.
It's pretty convenient, too. They sent it right out and had it repaired, so.
Yeah. Here you go. How about a steak dinner?
Mm-hmm.
Katrina Bookman was stunned as she took a selfie.
Is that Jane Bookman's mama?
With the queen shot of a machine.
Well, of course you do that. Everybody takes a selfie with the machine, right?
Yeah. I couldn't believe it. My body went dumb. My body went numb.
His body went dumb.
His did too.
I'm with you, man. Go ahead.
Her disbelief toned the anger and confusion the next day when representatives from New York informed her she was not entitled to her payout.
What?
Yeah. They offered her a free steak dinner.
Oh, well, you know, if you got $43 million in one hand and a steak dinner in the other, come on.
At least one to fill you up, right?
You know.
No.
You got to take a steak dinner.
Katrina Bookman said there was nothing wrong with it when I was playing the machine.
Well, of course. If I just won $43 million, I'd be like, nope, this machine's fine. Perfect inspection.
Yeah. Took my money. Good to go. Just fine.
Yeah, worked fine when took my money.
It was taken in for repair after the incident and later placed out on the floor.
Well, that's
and
a good.
They want to go check it out for it.
Yeah, that's a good excuse. Be like, you know what? I think the machine's broke because we don't like giving money away like that. So make sure something.
Didn't max pay on the machine was real low though, wasn't it?
Yeah, the machine payout was $6,500.
Yeah, $6,500 anyway. So
all right, well,
that's gonna be their out,
well,
you know.
Well, give me $6,500. We'll
call
it even.
That's what she said, I think.
Well, they have manager on the machine that won. Malfunction, void, all pay, and play.
Does it void that baseball bat when you walk back in there and start smashing stuff? I've seen the Walking Dead episode. I know how you get stuff done with the baseball bat.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There's a technique to it.
The Gaming Commission could only legally refund Bookman $2.25.
That's all they can legally refund, but they can't legally pay her out.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's just crazy, man. They can illegally keep her money, though.
She was obviously upset.
Yeah, obviously.
And she thought her life and family life would have been changed forever.
Well, of course, man.
It would have, yeah.
Of course, now. And do we have enough feedlots to raise enough beef? Do you know about that? Cow stuff.
Yeah, let's talk some moose stuff.
Do we have enough? Do we have to have feedlots? Do you have to have feedlots to raise enough beef? Do you?
Do I? You asking me if I believe we do?
Well, do you have to have feedlots, or can you get without feedlots?
I think you do. That's my opinion.
I think to meet the demand, and yes, you have to have them.
Because how many times have you been told that we don't have enough feedlots because we just don't have enough land to finish all the cattle on pasture?
Yeah, well.
Well, have you ever actually sat down and tried to figure out how much land it would take to pasture finish all the beef that we need in the U.S.?
Nope. Never have.
There's 29 million head of cattle finished in U.S. feedlots in 2014. It took about 15.5 million acres of cropland to generate the feed consumed by those animals. So if you take 15.5 million acres, sit it down with your grass mix, pasture mix, you manage it effectively, those same acres...
Carry the two.
Right. Those same acres should be able to finish about 25 million head of cattle as pasture. And that's over 85% of our feedlot output just using the same land for pasture instead of crops.
I want to know where this land located.
That's what I'd like to know.
What is this land that we can put the cattle on?
Right, and they're not talking about, are they including the land that's under ordinances that you can't have livestock?
Yeah.
You know.
You can't have cows out there. Well, see, we're at record.
But the land is there.
Well, so they're at a record low. You know, we're at record low levels of cows, so we should probably plan for the number of head that we were finishing 10 years ago.
That's
that was
changing.
About 35 million head.
That's changing right now.
Oh, yeah. So, because, you know, we had the feedlots.
Let me ask you a question. So are we vetting those cows that are coming in?
And
how is our vetting process for these cows?
And that's the question that I pose. Those of you that follow the show on Twitter, I pose that to the presidential candidates. Okay, at the time I posed the question. All right, before y'all start throwing stuff and crying and needing to not take tests because your brains can grow, but I posed it to both candidates. Okay. People running for presidency stuff. Anyway, I posed to both of them. Hey, you know what? Whichever one of you guys win this deal, come on the show with us and let's talk about cows.
Right on. Now, I got to take a quick shout out to Kaylee Arlette. Glad you joined us, Kaylee.
All right.
Another higher ground.
Higher ground?
Cowboy church out in East Texas.
Higher ground or higher trails?
Higher ground.
Everything's high out there.
Well, it is actually on a hill.
Except for the cows.
Hey, it's a good place to go, man. I'm not going to sit here and pump it other than it's a great place to go.
I've been there a few times.
Have you? Yeah. Not higher ground.
Higher ground.
No, you may have been on higher ground, but you ain't been to higher ground.
You've been to higher trails.
Or that higher ground.
You've been to higher trails.
Yeah. That's a great. Randy Bird. Great people. Yeah. Good to go. Anyway, enough about that. I'm going to ask you a question. And this goes, Bonnie, if you're listening, don't feel like you're the only one running around with alligators.
All right.
Did you hear about the 17-footer?
What?
Yeah, from a canal over in Sri Lanka.
What? Sri Lanka?
Sri Lanka.
That
in South America? I bet people are wondering if we go a week without an alligator story.
Oh, did y'all have one last time? See, that's what I get from missing.
We've had one for about the last, I don't know.
Well, I hate that I've been missing so much because I like alligator stories. This is actually a crocodile, so maybe we'll give it a break.
Well,
17 foot, 2,000 pounds.
Yeah, and that's what I tell them all the time. We'll look at it right there. Are you sure it was a crocodile or an alligator?
Well, it said crocodile.
Do you know how to tell the difference?
Well, yeah, it's a snout situation.
Well, no. One will see you later, and the other will see you after a while.
Oh.
they're like, you know, you tell that every week. For the past
you've heard of walking into one? Like yeah.
Look at that thing. They got him with a backhoe right there.
Yeah.
Billy and Beth.
Yeah, I've been being out there too.
Hey, hey, hey. Sorry, man, I can't help but read off these names that keep joining the show, especially new ones.
Talk about stuff. Let's go. What else are we going to talk about today? Oh, we got to call them people that sent text and email. Let's call them up.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Joe LePuy sent me an email.
Latrice. That's the name, right?
LePuy Jennifer. All
right. We're going. What was that?
Apparently, she's from my hometown where I live.
All right. Oh, your hometown where you live?
The town I live in, not my hometown.
Okay. So I need the information because I'm listening to Ring a Ding Ding. You said it's Latrice, right?
Yeah, LePuy.
Here we go. They ain't gonna be able to hear you, but they can hear me. So we gonna tell them.
You missing me?
Who?
You missing me?
Is that what the email said?
Hey, it's me. Can't answer the phone right now. You're back. Bye.
I was waiting on a.
Hey, Latrice. It's Wild Bill. You emailed me to call you. I was calling you, but you didn't answer the phone, so I guess I'll call you another time.
Your message has been saved. Goodbye.
Whoa, what was that?
Speed talker to leave a message on that one.
What?
I'm glad you didn't have no secret code you had to give her.
Man, I was going to tell him he's out hunting crocodiles. But they shut that down quick.
She was busy watching the show.
I doubt that. He got some random email. He got a random email. It's like, what did it say? Something about, hey.
Yeah, what up there? T-Bab, Lefee, yeah. Jennifer, from Killer. Yeah, here's my direct line. 5705
He's going to read it out. He's going to read it out.
But it's not the number that's spelled out.
Let's get the number out and everybody call him Bomber.
4-0-2-0 If you haven't checked it, I miss you, Stud.
So we know she sent the wrong email.
She did say Stud on there.
Well, that's how we know it's the wrong email.
Oh, yeah. She thought that was the state fair email for Big Tex.
Yeah. Big things. All right, what did we say? We talked to Bonnie, I guess, about PBR, right?
Yes.
PBR, okay. We said Cooper Davis won that, right?
Absolutely. Fantastic job.
Ryan Dirtier took second.
Yep. Go around or average winner.
Yes.
Yep.
I do want to say this. The PBR, all right, I'll tiptoe as much as possible since I've already been
reprimanded.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With the new... I don't know.
Just say it.
The new place took over the PBR. The new guys took over. They run things a little different. They're more on the entertainment side of it and less of the bull riding side of it. So, I mean, when people go to the bull riding, they want to see one of two things. They want to see somebody spur one for 90, or they want to see somebody get wrecked out.
Kind of like NASCAR, right?
Yeah. But the way things have been going, they're not so much on the wrecked out part of it.
Mm-hmm.
They're kind of grabbing them by the knot. What?
Being knots.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're kind of doing, you know, got those over here. You know, they're mm-hmm. getting kind of kitty-kitty on that deal and just wanting to be the bull riding and the entertainment, concerts. Because you saw concert after concert, which is great for entertainment, if you want entertainment, but it takes away from when people go to the bull riding, they want to see somebody wreck out and they want somebody ride one.
Yeah, the raw core of bull riding. I know what you're saying.
You
want to sure
have
everybody else does too.
You want to have both sides of it. Now.
Yeah.
We shot a video from round number one we posted, and it was out there for a while. It's not there anymore. Well, if you didn't see it, you missed it. That's all I can tell you. But that happened. It was a good deal. Some folks made some money, did some good stuff. Glaramy Marchie, if you didn't see what he had to say, he had said some good stuff about us, and he'll be back in here shortly.
Heck of a cowboy right there, man.
He put it on him for the finals. He put it on him.
He really did. Really enjoyed watching him.
Cattle prices. We hadn't done the Northeast Texas cattle market, whatever, because there is none. I mean, the prices are down.
It's a buyer's market right now.
What's Giggly doing over there? What's going on?
I don't know what he's giggling. What are you giggling about?
Hey, Jason.
What? You give a shout out to dudes now?
Come on, you're
huh? What? He's happy now. I don't know.
Shout out to my boy, Eric Franklin.
Is that Benjamin's boy?
I'm going to do that for a little while, so just bear with me.
Is that Benjamin's boy?
No, it's Eric Franklin, D.R. Horton guy.
Benjamin, that's Benjamin's boy.
Benjamin
okay. Franklin's boy, right?
I think it's James. But we'll go with that.
All right. Where are you seeing that anyway? I don't see that popping up.
I've got a private feed over here. No, I'm kidding. Right here.
Yeah, that's me. I'm here.
What?
And see, he was giving me a hard time for using my phone while ago instead of the iPad.
Yeah.
But I'm about four posts right here ahead of him.
Oh.
Uh-huh. See, I'm up on it. I'm up on it.
I think Glenn just called you out. I saw that.
Called me out?
No, Tex.
Oh.
Oh, chicken. Tex choked his chicken. We got that story right there.
Oh, Lordy, you gave me that piece of paper a while ago. I got to check this out. I started reading it.
That's an update from our story last week. That's our story from last week.
Come on, I lost it. You didn't tell I'm out of practice. I haven't been in here in a while. I'm a lot disorganized and everything. Yeah, done with choke chicken.
What?
All right. That's what you took. Never mind.
All right, let's go. Come on, Tex. You did that too, didn't you?
Come on, right. Tex. Tell us about the choke chicken.
What about the choke chicken?
I don't know choke chicken. I don't know chicken
in here. Right. Here, look.
Tell us about it. Tex talked about
him
last week.
Talked about the choke chicken. Let's go.
Didn't we do this story last week?
We did, but there's an update. Come
oh, update to this story. Well, do I need to read you the original story just in case?
Yeah, yeah, just in case somebody didn't catch it.
Somebody didn't catch it? All right. Last week, we told you about this. This is what we told you. A Mississippi attorney, Mississippi, M-I-S-S, attorney.
I-P-P-I.
Is suing Papa after he said he nearly choked to death on a piece of chicken because he had to eat it with his hand. He didn't have, yeah, they didn't give me no utensils. He filed a lawsuit. He ordered 2 chicken breasts, rice and beans, a biscuit, a soft drink.
I really don't know why you're doing that either.
You put a fly through the window in November.
More about your
but
Christmas
it only
decorations.
Came with a fork. It came with a fork.
Let me explain.
The lack of knife for the chicken forced him to take matters into his own hands. Literally.
This is not something we need to talk about.
And tear off pieces with his teeth.
What?
The man of the eating allegedly called him to start choking on a bite of his food.
Camel?
It ultimately resulted in this guy undergoing emergency surgery to remove the chicken from
was
his
that emoji surgery?
Emoji.
Oh, emergency. I'm sorry.
I heard you.
I thought he said emoji surgery. I thought it was part of the story. I ain't reading it.
It really happened. It almost he almost choked to death and he had to eat chicken with his hands.
That's appalling.
Here's the update. The attorney said that he is dropping the suit against the popular fast food chain after receiving a clean comment directed to me and my family.
That is ridiculous.
I continue to believe that the fat demonstrate an unsafe condition to the public that could easily be solved by the responsible party at very little cost. All you gotta do is give a fork and a chicken. All you gotta do is give a fork.
When you're a little bitty kid, I'm sorry. Where?
Well, I'm not done.
All right, tell me about it.
I am hopeful that my filing of the court proceeding will result in some remedial action, he said in the email.
All right, this guy's Mississippi. Mississippi's in the South, too, right? We're in the South. We're in the South.
I think they got alligators, too. Oh, I'm not supposed to keep talking about alligators, am I?
When you're a kid growing up, about 2 years old, 3 years old, you learn how to eat chicken. You know what's got bones, what kind of bones are in each piece of chicken. So if you're a grown man driving through the drive-thru, evidently if you can drive a vehicle, you can drive through the drive-thru. So you ought to be old enough to know how to eat chicken. And what's what?
He was forced to eat chicken with his hand. He was forced to.
What do you eat chicken with?
They stood there over him and forced him to eat it.
When you eat fried chicken, what are you eating fried chicken with?
Fingers.
You ain't got your silver spoons and knives and golden forks.
I don't know. I'm pretty good with the fork, man.
What?
You can debone. I'll just leave it alone. Yeah. I'm with you. With your drumstick, I'm in. Hands only.
Oh yeah,
son, you're teasing the gorilla in the monkey house.
Oh,
but yeah, you learn how to eat chicken as a kid. You eat chicken. You know how to eat the chicken. You know how to work the chicken. You eat it with your hands. You don't eat it with a fork. Who eats fried chicken with not their hands? Come on now.
Right.
My deal. He wanted a knife, but he would have gave him a knife. I bet he would have cut his hand off with it.
He might have cut his finger.
They need to suit him for that.
Yeah.
It's kind of like the hot coffee thing.
Well, all right. Don't get into that one now.
It's settled. Don't worry.
Huh?
It's settled.
Yes, but do you know the whole story?
I know enough.
What do you know?
Not enough, apparently.
Well, not
because apparently you're holding out on me.
Because it's a good
story. All I can say is if Pepper says, do you know the whole story, I'm going to shut up and listen.
Do you know the whole story? Okay, here's what happened.
The coffee was too hot, and he spilt it on her and bumped her leg.
She had second. All right, here's what happened. This incident right here is what caused temperature regulations on coffee.
Oh, yeah.
Because it was so hot, it burnt her. She had second, third degree burns in her legs and her.
I got you. I'm with you.
Private parts.
I'm with you. I'm with you.
It had to have stuff done.
Oh.
To fix things.
That's the same deal?
Yeah.
Oh, well, see, I didn't get that part.
See,
that's why when he starts telling that kind of thing, you got to be quiet. Because
I didn't
he's always got that little extra tidbit.
Oh, yeah.
That changes everything.
Can I avoid this?
How he does it, I don't know, Tex. I mean.
Investigative reporting. Something millennial kids know nothing about.
Hey, usually I'm pretty good at that stuff because my wife will tell you, I'm a Google man. I'm like, if I need to know it, I'll Google it right then.
Well, I was watching a deal on stuff on TV, and they were going over different incidents that happened throughout time or whatever that people didn't know the whole story to, because that's what I thought. I was like, oh well, you know, ding dong, you get coffee, it's hot, well, of course it's gonna burn you. But then when I got the whole story and found out
made more sense.
Thousands of dollars for the surgeries and the burns and all that. I was like, oh, well,
they had it too hot. You're right. I stand
hot.
Corrected. And now that I know all that, lady, I'm behind you.
Yeah. And it was an old lady, too.
Oh, yeah. I'm even more behind
her. She's really old.
Yeah.
I feel sorry for the doctor. I had to go work on that. But, yeah, it was a terrible deal. But, you know, that's one of those things that, you know, stuff happens. Stuff happens. And
What other stuff's happening? Come on, tell me some more.
Australian man got a $9,000 fine for using a drone to deliver his sausage.
says a sausage.
Oh, that sounds like a tech story.
clarify that.
This is in Australia, though.
Well, that's true. Anything goes.
The Civil Aviation Safety Authority of Australia is investigating a viral video involving a man using a drone to deliver sausage.
Without a permit.
It's like another video I saw. The official CASA YouTube account commented on the YouTube video, which has since been removed, warning of a potential $9,000 fine. Now, is that $9,000 Australian money or U.S. of A money? I don't know. They're currently reviewing the video for compliance with Australia's aviation safety regulations. The comment reads, breaching these laws with illegal drone flights may attract fines between $500 and $9,000. The video featured the drone flying to local business hardware retailer to pick up a sausage. Now, why are you going to a hardware store picking up sausage?
I guess they're...
Tex, you know anything about this?
Yeah. Ace Hardware just got a tip.
So what?
They sell everything else.
They go to the hardware store. I'm sure they sell the tip, too. Go to the hardware store to pick up a sausage, which later flew over a residential area to deliver to a man in a hot tub. So they went to the hardware store and got some sausage and delivered it to a guy in a hot tub. I'm glad I don't proofread this stuff.
I know, right?
CASA spokesman Peter told the Sydney Morning Herald that the action of the video breaches regulations involving using a drone with the approximately 100 feet of people, as well as using a drone outside of line of sight. You can clearly see people walking to and from their cars. You can clearly see people around the sausage sizzle. The drone pilot, who identified himself as Tim, said the video was just a bit of fun. Instead, he cropped shots from multiple flights together to make it appear like one continuous trip. So the drone would have lost signal over this, blah, 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 blah. Spokesman said, however, the company did clear the flight and deferred all inquiries to the CASA. This is a classic example of a place where you should never fly a drone.
And that's the end of season one's premiere right there. It's a saga.
That's one of them deals.
Oh, it's a sausage.
That's one of them sausage fest deals where people watch the video and then they got all upset and try to sue people. And he's like, that's not one whole video.
Hey,
guys.
My hat's off to the dude in the hot tub, man. I mean...
Is that the first time you got sausage in the hot tub?
Oh, man. Oh, give me something to throw at him.
No.
What do you got to figure out? What
do you? Oh, we got to figure out something. Let's get back to rodeo or something,
what do you
man.
Got, what do you got over text? What do you got? What do you got? What do you got?
What do you find?
Son, would you please knock it off? You're driving me nuts.
I got something about Kevin Bacon flat down by Canadian police.
What? Well, tell us in the microphone.
Oh, Kevin Bacon.
Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute. It's fugitive.
Oh, fugitive pig. Kevin Bacon. Put down by Canadian police.
Tracked him down, huh?
He was footloose.
A police in Canada managed to pat down an escaped pig in a local neighborhood before returning it to its owner.
I hear Canada's going to get busy here like, pretty soon.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's going to move to Canada. I mean, they got more jobs going to open up down in America. Everybody's moving to Canada. That means we're going to have job opening.
Well, that just means we'll have more land for the cows.
It's going to be
we'll
cold.
We'll knock the house right down and have more land.
Yes. Nova Scotia. Hello?
the police. police jail photo. Yeah, he knelt down with a fugitive pot-bellied pig. Oh, there he is.
There's the picture.
There's the picture. That's a cool picture. yeah.
I'm glad there's safety rail on the side of this chair.
We were calling out the local police area of Dartmouth to help with tongue Kevin Bacon, a pot-bellied pig who had fled away from his home. They encounter Kevin Bacon.
The encounter.
Yeah, they encountered Kevin Bacon. Yeah, was the first time he dealt with a pig on the job, and he enjoyed the opportunity to have a laugh. we located him in the north end area, and he was happy to cheer. He had a little fun with him then. we got a lot of pictures with him.
Whoa.
And then he went off with the owner.
Oh, Lord.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. You know, when you get a pot-bellied pig, you're randomly running around. You got to take pictures with it. Yeah, I take pictures of everything.
Yeah, you would take a picture
of everything.
It'd be pork butt. we got to give you a hard time, man.
You got to take pictures of everything. You got front, back, side,
what
top,
is it like? What do we
bottom?
Go? What do we go through? About 300 shots and 275 where something's butt?
Yeah.
Peggy.
I got to get an overview.
An overview.
A 380 overview. I mean, 350.
I'm with you. Hey, man, I'm with your philosophy. You go right ahead with it.
380 is a highway. Although he did.
He said, you did say 380, didn't you? Well, that's going all the way around then some. That's what that
yeah.
is.
He did slip up when he ran into his hero today. He did run into his hero in the elevator.
Oh, yeah. I got in trouble with you on that one, didn't
in
I?
The elevator coming up, Tex ran into his hero. And
I'm going to wear me.
He got froze. He froze up.
Tomorrow.
Did you freeze up or you talk? What happened?
I freeze up. I was speechless.
He's going home and tie-dying some bridges tonight.
Yeah.
I know he is.
So tomorrow at the rodeo, you know, in Las Vegas at the rodeo, I'm probably going to wear your little Fallon Taylor pants.
Do it.
You'll fit right in, dude. You're going to Vegas.
I'm going to walk down. You think I look good walking downtown Vegas?
Practice your best, Elvis.
With rainbow pants? I'm going to wear rainbow pants, rainbow choke.
There you go. You'll be all right.
What
rainbow
do you do?
Hat.
What
walk
do you
down
do
the street to Las Vegas.
Just take lots of pictures. That's all we have. Our pictures that are legibility photos.
Hey, there's a familiar face we saw today.
Who's that?
Trevor.
Yeah, you know, I think Trevor is trying to. Is he incognito or what? Because he had to put that beard, growing a beard, or is it because it's November? I don't know. What do you think?
Well, I
no
mean,
shave November.
I guess. I didn't recognize him from the side at first. When he was riding around, I seen the Relentless shirt, and I thought, well, wait a minute, that looks like Trevor. And then, you know, I was like, wait a minute, he's got a beard.
You know who I didn't see? I didn't see Tuff.
Tuff Cooper.
You know what? I didn't either, now that you brought that up.
I saw his brother.
Cliff, yeah.
Where was Tuff?
I don't know. Maybe he just didn't make it in yet.
I was going to run to him. I was going to give him a hard time. I was going to give him a hard time anyway. Yeah. Come on. Come on up here tonight.
The weather was kind of bad for you to drive in, so.
Yeah,
maybe got caught in the weller.
I bet.
What, all that sunshine was glaring in the front windshield?
Yeah. Tough, I tell you. What other stories you got over?
I'm done with my story.
You know, over you said Nova Scotia. What was it, Nova Scotia, a while ago? We were talking about something
Nova Scotia.
That was the we just talked about Nova Scotia, didn't we?
We got to wake. We got to get going here. We're going to put our audience to sleep.
Well, that.
Hey, that's about the cat and the deer.
I got a phone with Holy date to get to.
I thought that's what it was.
Good. Yeah, there's a video for that. I was going to pull it up, but I forgot.
You mean read it to you and tell you what it's about?
Yeah, tell me about that.
All right, Nova Scotia. The cat. The caption says, cat forms unlikely friendship with family of deer. Not just one. Family of deer. So here we go. Like Bible Hill, Nova Scotia. A Nova Scotia woman captured video of her animal whisperer. She just said her animal whisperer cat.
All right.
So I guess that's his name. It's in caption, animal whisperer.
Okay.
Cat playing with some of his most unlikely friends, a family of deer. Karina Saunders posted a video on Facebook showing her cat. There you go, folks, if y'all want to look it up. Karina Saunders posted a video of, to Facebook showing her cat, Benoy. Well, I thought his name was Animal Whisperer. Playing with the mother of deer and twin fawns in her Bible Hill backyard. Saunders and Benoy seem to have had formed a particular close bond with one of the female youngsters. And the mama and her twin babies came up to Ben. Ben decided it was going to play with the little girl. And again, they were chasing each other around the backyard. Saunders told the CBS mainstream radio. Benoy and the deer, which Benoy we know now as a cat. Benoy and the deer can be seen touching one another multiple times in the video. And the cat even has both front paws on the deer's neck at one point.
Meow.
Saunders said she has seen Benoy and the deer touch noses in a kiss during another visit. This is really going south. She wrote on Facebook, the animal whisperer. Cat's other unlikely wildlife friends include red foxes, a pheasant, and even a skunk.
Oh, that's
so,
that
kind of
like a...
Miss Karina Saunders is a Dr. Doodle-Little. Not Doodle-Little, but Doodle-Little. up there in Nova Scotia. Lord have mercy, what's this world coming to when the cat's pawing the deer?
I apologize for yelling at you.
Hey, that kind of like my kind of neighborhood.
Hey, I've got a cat that just darn near might do something like that, to be honest with you. We got, when you can get her off the couch.
That woman you talked about, right? Is she single? That you want
to What?
Well, I don't know, but Nova Scotia is quite a plane ticket if you want to pay for it.
You going to grab the cat or what?
Yeah, I mean, grab her.
You got quiet real quick.
How do you respond to that?
All right, check this out, people. Santa Fe, New Mexico, right here. Artist creates.
Democratic city now.
Artist creates functional pottery using human remains.
Oh, yuck.
New Mexico-based artist, Chronicle Cremation Designs, creates unique custom memorial objects, like functional dinnerware out of human remains.
Did you just say dinnerware?
Functional dinnerware out of human remains. What started out as a personal project following the death of a loved one has blossomed into a successful enterprise offering a variety of usable memorial.
I'm with you.
I was like, I didn't think I read that right, but it did say usable. Whew. Memorial products coated in a custom ash glaze. Creating objects that tell stories is my passion. The inspiration for the Chronicle came following a death of which led to a period of personal growth.
In other words, it got weird.
Yeah. Instead of observing an urn or a photograph on a shelf, I wanted a way to interact with memories on a daily basis. Our product was born out of the desire to keep those who lived before us remembered in daily life. They let you integrate the memories into everyday life and use them, interact with them, and see them on an everyday basis. He creates bowls, mugs, vases, and even jewelry coated in ash glaze.
You know, I might could go with this if it was like a statue, but plates and cups.
I'm not going to eat my chicken off a plate of a dead body.
No.
Why not?
How you like that chicken, Fred?
Tastes kind of burnt.
Tastes kind of burnt.
I'll try anything you want.
Yeah, he will. I saw the video.
You know, I like your positive attitude.
You might want to get checked. You may be positive. I don't know.
Oh.
No, I don't know.
That's why he's moving to Nova Scotia.
It's cold up there.
You know
there.
What you said?
Stuff don't grow. So we already did the Australia.
I think we put everybody to sleep. There ain't nobody saying nothing on here now. It's been a while.
I think we lost him on that, on Tex and his cats. I don't know.
I know, man.
We had cow stuff, too. I don't know.
Yeah, come on.
We had stuff. What time? It's already time to leave.
You're kidding me. We talked this long?
We always do. See, that's what.
Is it really?
It's what always happens.
That's what it is. They're all like, hey, it's time to get out of here.
We need to talk. You know, but, hey, you know what? Stuff's going on downtown. ERA stuff's going on downtown.
Yep.
Tonight.
We'll be there.
Tonight stuff's going on. They're having the kickoff party tonight, but we are not going until mañana. We're going to be Friday, Saturday, Sunday. We'll be there bringing you guys stuff from the ERA World Finals.
That's right.
And other than that, I don't know what to tell you guys.
First World Finals.
The first ever. Some say.
How much is that purse, Pepper?
How big is your purse? It's 1.5.
Is it 1.5?
I believe.
Or 1 million?
Well, it changed.
Yeah.
It's anywhere.
It's a lot of money.
Anywhere from $1 million to $1.5 million. Somewhere in there. It originally started out as a $3 million deal, and there was also a longer vinyl, but then they kind of did some Hong Kong fooey and chopped it up and made it smaller. So, smaller, more compact, which is good, because in downtown Dallas, you don't want to be trying to get in downtown for more than 2 or 3 days at a time during the week, because it's a mess.
Yeah.
So that was a good deal. But, it's going to be a good deal, good event. We'll be there talking about stuff, talking to folks, shooting pictures, videos, and I don't know how much we're going to do as far as daily posting and daily stuff from the event, but as far as by the time you see us live again, I will say live because people watch replays. Next time you see us live again, we'll have some good action for you guys, possibly a good video of some shots. We're going to do some videography, some photography, and some breaking stuff over there. I don't know. I think he broke his phone.
I haven't happened to doing that.
It was a cat.
Don't break your phone.
He gets a new phone every month.
Yeah.
And he breaks
it. Yeah, I'll break it.
Anyway, just remember.
I think it might be a keeper for me to buy a phone. I mean, buy a number. You get a different number every week.
Yeah,
because it keeps breaking.
Well, I'm excited about it. Rodeo time in Dallas, Texas.
It's gonna be some good stuff. So we're gonna have to. What are you doing over there?
You got him saluting you now.
I know. Like, what is going on?
That's pretty good. Is. You're getting him trained. I like it.
He's working on it.
I got my phone on his iPad. No.
It's called timing out.
Oh, timing.
Yeah, inactivity.
This party is officially over.
This is where we say peace out.
Peace out, my. Peace
yeah.
out.
Whoa.
He was going to say my friends.
I hope so.
He was going to say
my people.
I hope that's what he's going to say. So anyway.
Big shout out to all my friends out there. Peace out.
So we're out of here. We'll be back. Text Travis on the Facebook. You got Steve Adair, announcer man, something like that on Facebook. Check him out. The Pepper Stewart Show, everything else going on. PepperStewart.com. Look around. Have a look around. Those wanting the T-shirts and stuff like that, we finally got around to putting the T-shirts on the website. So just go on there and get whatever you want. We don't care. Just go check it out and wear it. If you do wear it, when you do wear it, take a picture. Send it to us. We'll put you on the interweb net. But other than that, y'all have a good time. We are going to get out of here on the highways, byways of Texas. Hopefully we can make it through the roads without any blockage. And other than that, we will see you guys this weekend.